Hello and welcome back to the channel. In this lecture, we are going to talk about one of the service models of cloud computing, which is infrastructure as a service, which is also known as IaaS. So there are mainly three service models of cloud computing, which we have discussed in the previous lectures, such as IaaS, PaaS and SaaS. So today we are going to talk about IaaS here. So without further ado, let's get into it. So infrastructure as a service will provide us the access for fundamental resources such as physical machines, virtual storage and etc. So apart from these resources, the IaaS also provides us the following resources such as virtual machine disk storage as well as virtual local area network, load balancers, IP addresses and software bundles. So all of these resources are made available to end user via server virtualization. So moreover, these resources are accessed by the customers as if they own them. So this will give you a full control on computing power as well as hardware that you require. So this picture will give you a clear idea of on-premise versus IaaS versus PaaS and SaaS. So as you can see, the IaaS will give you the access for managing the applications, data, runtime, middleware and OS. And the vendors will manage virtualization, servers, storage and networking. And from this picture, you can visualize what really is the difference among these three major service models of cloud computing. So as you can see, PaaS will only give you access for applications and data, and for SaaS, you are not having much control on computing and storage. All the things will be managed by the cloud vendors and you will only consume the applications which are provided by your cloud vendors. So this is how these three main service models will differentiate as compared to the on-premise software that I have given here. So now let's talk about the characteristic of IaaS. So here I have given the five main characteristic of IaaS. First one, it will give us the virtual machines with a pre-installed software as well as the pre-installed operating system such as Windows, Linux and Solaris as per your requirement. It is also give us the on-demand availability of resources. The next one is it will allow us to store copies of particular data at different locations for backing up the data. And the last one is the computing resources can be easily scaled up and scaled down according to your requirement. So it will make us very cost effective as you will only pay for the resources that you are using. Now let's talk about the benefits of IaaS over PaaS, SaaS and on-premise service. So the IaaS will allow the cloud provider for freely locating the infrastructure over the internet and in a very cost-effective manner. So some of the key benefits I have listed here. So first one is it will give us the full control of computing resources through the administrative access to the virtual machines. So IaaS will allow the customer for accessing computing resources through administrative access to virtual machines in two ways. So customer issues administrative command to cloud provider for running the virtual machines or to save the data on cloud servers. And the second way is the customer issues administrative command to virtual machines they owned to start web server or to install new applications. The next benefit is flexible and efficient renting of the computer hardware. So IaaS resources such as virtual machines, storage devices, bandwidth, IP addresses, as well as the monitoring services and firewalls for security purpose. So these are made available to the customer on rent and the payment is based upon the amount of time customer retains the resource. So also with administrative access, the customer can run any software, even a custom operating system as well. So this will give you full control on the service. And the last one is portability, interoperability with the legacy applications. So it is possible to maintain a legacy between applications and the workloads between IaaS clouds. So for example, networking applications such as web servers or the email servers that are normally run on customer-owned server hardwares can also run from the virtual machines in IaaS clouds. But there are some issues in IaaS. So let's talk about that now. So IaaS shares issues with PaaS and SaaS such as the network dependence and the browser-based risk. So it also has some specific issues that I have given here. So let's talk about them one by one. The first one is compatibility with legacy security vulnerabilities. So because IaaS provides the customer to run legacy software in provider's infrastructure, it exposes customers to all of the security issues of such legacy softwares. The next issue is virtual machine sprawl. So the virtual machine can become out of date with respect to the security updates because the IaaS will allow customer to operate virtual machines in running, suspended as well as op state. But however, the provider can automatically update such VMs, but this mechanism is hard and very complex. So this is one disadvantage of IaaS. The next one is robustness of VM level isolation. So IaaS offers an isolation environment to individual customers through the hypervisor. So the hypervisor is nothing but a software layer that includes hardware support for virtualization to split a physical computer into multiple virtual machines. So if you want to know more about hypervisor, we have a dedicated video regarding cloud computing architecture. So if you want to know more, just click on the I button where I have given the whole playlist to learn cloud computing basics. And the last issue is data erase practices. So the customer uses virtual machines that in turn use the common disk resources provided by the cloud provider. So when the customer releases the resources, the cloud provider must ensure that the next customer to rent the resource does not observe the data which is residual from the previous customer. So this will lead us to the privacy issues to our sensitive data. So this was all about the issues related to IaaS. So in this lecture we have seen what is IaaS and how it's differentiate as compared to the PaaS, SaaS and the on-premise services. And we have also seen the benefits of IaaS in detail as well as the disadvantages of IaaS as compared to the other service models. So if you like this lecture, please subscribe to our channel and ring the notification bell to get the latest updates. And don't forget to follow us on our social media that I have linked in the description below. Thanks for watching.